These are the London studios of the Moving Picture Company, which, amongst many other things, has made a speciality of these very rarefied special effects techniques. So let's see how they made that sequence.
Okay, can you just check that, please, Damon? Can you check the...
Of course, a great deal of work happens before the pictures start coming through a television studio control room like this one. For a start, because of the complex nature of this equipment, not to mention the cost of actually hiring it, it's very important to decide in advance precisely what you want to do. So in this case, as in most cases like this, our graphics designer, Chris Jennings, came along to the company, and in consultation with the director and using a storyboard, they worked out precisely where the special effects should appear, what those special effects should show, and whether indeed it was possible to make them at all. And after that, it's merely a question of making up the sequence. Well, I've got the sequence as far as we've made it here on the videotape machine, and if we go through it in stages, I'll try and explain to you exactly how it was done in each individual element. If you remember, the sequence starts off with this rather nice effect here, which in fact is an effect of stars. And you can see that they're twinkling. Well, I'd love to be able to tell you that this was an amazingly complicated high technology effect. It isn't. Nothing could be simpler. What they did was they got a big piece of black card, punched little holes in it, put lights behind it, and put a piece of material between the lights and the card, which they blew with a fan. The result, you have stars that twinkle. The next thing that happened was that a computer keyboard zoomed in like this and established a position in the middle of the picture. Now, this was done by using a real computer keyboard attached to something called a motion control rig. This is a mechanical device which holds both the camera and the object you're photographing in a complex rig system. And through computer control, they can both be made to move in the same set of planes. And of course, because it is computerized, that move can be repeated over and over again, or you can make minor adjustments until the effect you want is precisely right. And that took this keyboard down to there, by which time it had been joined by the VDU screen. This was done as a separate shot and simply spliced in or superimposed over the keyboard picture. We now have both the elements there, like so. The next thing that happened was that they both went into a nice halo effect. Now that looks very much, doesn't it? Rather like an artist painting with an airbrush. Not surprisingly, that's exactly how it was done. Not with a physical airbrush, but with an electronic paint box. What the artist simply did was to take an electronic light pen and paint round those two objects until he produced that effect. So, after that halo effect, two other effects come into play. First of all, I'd like to ask you to ignore the information on the VDU screen itself. The first effect we want to look at is this one. It's the move-in, which is again motion control. The second effect is the one on the screen there, which is an electronic generation of information through a Quantel electronic effects generator, which has been fed with some pretty coloured lines and then told to keep looking at itself. In other words, it's showing a picture of coloured lines looking at a picture of coloured lines looking at a picture of coloured line. From there, we move to another motion control sequence. We go through the coloured lines and we hit, for the first time in this whole operation, a piece of film, genuine computer graphics of a representation of a computer motherboard, which looks like that. Now, this is achieved by tracing round a blueprint of a genuine motherboard with this digitizing device. This places the parameters into a computer to enable the software to represent it in a three-dimensional form and from any angle. And the digitized plan of the whole device looks like this. The information can then be called up from memory and plotted by a fiber optic pen, the image of which is photographed by a Mitchell camera straight onto 35mm negative film. Interestingly, in these days of video, still the finest quality image you can find on the screen. And it's in this shot that I appear. But remember, I'm on videotape, so how do I get into the middle of a piece of film? The answer, of course, is in post-production afterwards. Back to the television control room, where the editor marries the film and tape together. Very Doctor Who and the TARDIS.
Bring him up.
Database brings you the inside story of computers.